Hello. I just realized I hadn't sent this to my iPad, so I'll just send it to my iPad, sorry. How is everyone? Or nobody? That's fine. I am going to redraw something that I drew years ago, which was this cute little cloud sheep. For a bit of backstory, I had just got back into drawing and I was doing a character a day challenge, the prompt for this one was farm, and I knew I wanted to do a sheep, And then for some reason I tried to make it look like those light up clouds. Do you know those cloud light things? Let me show you. Cloud lamp maybe? Let's try that. Yeah. So my idea was initially to try and make my sheep look like that, like it was illuminated. And at the time I didn't have an iPad and I was just using markers. And so it was a bit of a challenge. And I don't think I achieved that at all, to be honest, in the final product. But I think doing digital, it might be a bit easier, especially to get that illuminated feel. These are really cool. I've seen people make them with like a water bottle, an empty water bottle, stuffing it with fairy lights and then wrapping foam stuff around it. Anyway, I'll get started and I'll just keep waffling on. I'm just gonna eat. Sorry. I'll break it now so that it's ready. Oh, thanks, Darren. I'll see you later. So I'm trying this new, trying a bit of a new format. I'm eating raspberry licorice block, Daryl Lee. Not sponsored. How good is raspberry licorice though? It's amazing. Anyway, I'm sorry. You're getting a bit of ASMR eating noises while I do this. I need to, I was just suddenly really tired. I don't know why. I think sometimes I get, excited, anxious, something or other. And it actually makes me tired. I know that sounds totally dumb, but it happens. It's true. It happens to me, I promise. So something I want to achieve with this redraw is a few things. A, hi Dad. A, I'd like to like make it look more illuminated, like it's got light coming out of the fleece. B, I don't know if you can see, but where his legs are feels a bit off to me. But also I'd like to add some kind of movement so it feels like he's coming down or jumping or something, you know. So I don't know how to achieve that, but maybe making little kind of bits. Anyway, that's where my head's at. I really want to be able to see the bottom of him, if that makes sense. So I make them out of balls mostly because that's cute. Round things are cute. That's how it works. I don't make the rules. I just play by them. That sounded really dumb, I'm sorry. I almost want to have a sense of where the bottom of each sphere is. Just in my head, I think. Maybe I'll make all of them sort of stretched a little bit, so it's like he's jumping. Something's rattling on my desk. Can you hear that? No. No, it's just me going insane, that's all. Don't worry. I've got a new standing desk and it does move. I don't mind it moving, but it's just something to get used to. I deliberately did a landscape size of the canvas. You can hear the rattling. Great. I think it's better. So I deliberately chose to do Gregory, Steve. I deliberately chose to do a landscape canvas. There you go. I've got it now. That's good. I'm glad it's gone. I deliberately chose to do a landscape canvas because I want to eventually have a landscape background, because I think that's what this other one was missing. And initially I was learning about character design, and one important factor to consider in character design is how your hair's parted. One important factor is size. So how big is your character? And sometimes using a point of reference, such as this tiny person standing underneath, gives you a sense of how big or small the character is. And in this case, you know, if that little guy wasn't there, oh, I can't crop him out. But if he wasn't there, it'd just look like a sheep jumping. You wouldn't get this idea of scale. Anyway, keep drawing. As usual, any questions, please just like shout them out, that's fine. have his tongue showing a bit more. His ears could also be going with the direction. Help that. I think. Anyway, how is everyone? It's a great idea. You can count my sheep. There's two. Sorry for the spoiler. Also, what do you think of my new format? So I've got rid of all the frames. Trying to maximize the space a bit more. I thought that was kind of cool. What do you think? Any? Any thoughts? I'm gonna do like a mountain valley, I think. Something like that. Not good at like showing movement and stuff, I don't think. It's new to me. I'm not sure, because there's certain ways to draw it, but I like to learn the theory, the sort of theory behind it. The sort of theory, not the actual theory, just the sort of theory. Gonna bring his bottom jaw down a bit. So hopefully he looks a bit happier, more excited. I feel like that's hard to see in the sketch. Everything seems a little out of focus. Shouldn't be. I hope that's just your internet or something. what else might help with the movement is curving his limbs a bit. I know they're kind of just stumps, but I'll leave that one down there. Alright, let's move to colouring, why not? Let's do it. I just want to maybe save this. Oops. Can I save? Save image. Actually, where's one with more? Ah, that'll do. So I think what I'll do is I'll start from the darks, because that's usually a good way. I'm just going to color pick. Weird how that works. It's almost like it's brighter in the creases. It's almost like a reverse. I think that's why it didn't work on my original one. Anyway, always learning though, aren't we? That's what I'm here doing. Excited just then and started just drawing random colors everywhere. I know, oh, it's already been 25 minutes, but I just need a quick loo break. I'm sorry. I'm gonna be really quick, I promise. Really quick. Don't go anywhere. Oh no! Sorry. Sorry. That's my bad. I can't believe I forgot to turn my mic back on. I just didn't want you to hear me going to the bathroom. What an idiot. Anyway, what I was saying was, I can't remember now. Don't do anything with a rainbow when you're just starting out. It's not worth it. It's not worth your life. Because it is so frustrating. Excuse me. Anyway, can't believe I did that. So sorry. I remember when I first painted this guy, I deliberately did some white around his eye so that you can see it better. So you can see that he's happy. He's a happy, jumpy cloud. Good, that's what I want. I think I can also, add some highlights here and stuff so it looks like there's actual light coming from within as well. Thanks, Jake. It is generally back in order. Still got the brace on occasionally, but just to keep it in check. not quite. As amazing as I want it to be. Actually, I might. Yeah, I think I'm getting it. Just need to add more definition. It's pretty cute. I can see where it's going. Some saturation helps. It does look a little bit ice creamy, but I don't know that that's a bad thing, really. I'll turn this off. Feet are a little weird. I'm not sure what I'm doing there. It's actually really weird to be making him illuminated, but he's got this inner illumination that's illuminating his limbs. That's weird to think about. don't like that. reimagining. Recreating, but with digital tools now, so I can actually make him more illuminated, which is what I was initially trying to do many moons ago. I don't know what I'm doing with this background. Something I need to work on really is backgrounds. That's why with the big boys I just take photos. But I mean, it's essentially always the same concept. You just... using shapes and making things... Yeah, this is the dark mode of the other one. Maybe I can commission White Knight to do it. I don't know. Should I stop? I should stop. Going for time. It hasn't been an hour yet, so that's fine. I'm happy to keep going. Let's just define his mouth and face a little bit more. Has anyone seen why doesn't your color of background go over the sheep? Oh, because I've got it on a layer behind here. So the way the layer stacking works is whatever's at the top is on top, on the front. So if you think of these layers like front to back as you go down, that's how it works. So I can paint on that layer without affecting the rest of it, which is pretty, pretty, pretty handy, wouldn't you say? Oh, hang on, what have I done? I'm doing the, so yeah, that's right. No worries. No stupid questions. I don't know how to make his look more like it's coming out. Maybe. Yes, that's better. Defining some of his hoof. His oof. No, it's still not right, is it? Something wrong. Maybe actually if I better. I feel like if I don't think too much about it, it's better. Well, hopefully you've sort of seen how I like to think about things when I draw. As in, like, I like to try and understand what the physics are that go into whatever's happening. And also kind of simplify them, I suppose, into things that I can understand, like how I was saying, I could kind of see that it was lighter in the creases, and, you know, why is that? Why would it be doing that? I'm not quite sure how to do the base yet. Maybe it does need a little bit of a animation. It's always good when Mum thinks he looks happy. It's a good test of what's going on. How's Penny? How's the dog? Have you heard anything? So just for context, anybody watching, my parents' dog was attacked. Hope I'm allowed to share that information. Of your pick from internet. Yes, it was. You're right.
Yeah.
Poor Penny. I'm sorry to hear that happened. A little bit more like a dog than a sheep, but I'm okay with it. I think I'm okay with going with that. This is good. I'm onto something now. Adding these really lighter, almost white bits. It's really giving it that sense of illumination. Hopefully a little bit of cloudiness, I think, as well. You can see a lot lower on this camera. See? It's embarrassing. remember a while ago during lockdown, I was drawing a barbarian. And my friend caught me going, as I was drawing, trying to get the expression right. Alright, I think I should probably stop. Got somewhere though, at least. Even if it's just an understanding of how light lit up wool works. I don't know, what do you think? Looks kind of illuminated, doesn't it? Really got to learn to say stop, stop. Draw a little person. Oops. That's not what I want to do. Thank you. that'll eventually become a person. Yeah, I think it's coming along. I think it's interesting. I almost want the valley lit up in rainbows too. I don't know if I'll get to that stage. Stop. Stop, Steven. Stop. 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 What are you doing? Anyway, I'll stop now. Thanks for watching. I will see you next time. I'm sure I'll finish him off. I don't know. This week's busy. Speaking of busy, actually, Friday night, Friday the 30th of April, group exhibition, opening night, 6 p.m. Brunswick Street Gallery. It's called Out Exhibition. I think I'm one of 24 or 25 artists. Lots of amazing stuff there. Come have a look, say hello to me. I'm sure it'll be really awkward, but you can say hi. Bye.